There he is. Pull up some crud and make yourself comfortable. I was just hiding out until the storm outside blows us all to Oz. Did you hear the rifle go off? Yeah, someone stole it from that kid on night patrol. Why do you think I'm in here? Coward. Easy trap. That was just a joke. Of course I went to...
That's right. The great Hawkeye Pierce saves the day again.
Where's this coming from? No, let me rephrase that. Where's any of this coming from? Have you ever noticed? Have you ever noticed how you always have to be right? It's like everyone in this whole camp is expected to answer to you. Have you ever noticed that when you get in a mood, you start criticizing me?
Why don't you just ride off on your high horse and leave us alone?
Yeah. Well, why don't you...
Boys, please. What started all of this?
We don't know. That's right, the genius detective hasn't figured it out yet. But if he spent a little less time swilling martinis, he might be able to detect that he's the problem.
Everything's a joke.
McIntyre, please, don't say anything you don't mean. Look, now that I'm back, how about we all get together for a kind of a party? A gathering of souls. Hopefully we could all get on the same page over some piano tunes and cards. Maybe you could persuade your friend Max to sing a little or dance if he's up to it. You said he'd be on his way soon. I know it seems impossible now, but... things will right themselves again. Well, when they do, just tell him to keep away from me. How do you like that? What's wrong with us? We've been under pressure before, and we may have snapped at each other, but this is the whole darn outfit. We aren't even under heavy fire right now. No casualties to stitch back together. It doesn't make sense. Getting along was always so easy to do when we had time to do it. What exactly happened, Hawkeye? I don't know. A few practical jokes, and things started to get less funny fast. Someone stole towels and the nurse's shower, you know, but Radar said whoever it was had a camera with them, took pictures.
Oh, my. Perhaps
I thought the same thing, Father. Max could have, but no, this is something else. It's like everyone's been drinking bad water and it's making them crazy, turn on each other. Maybe Frank has finally started to rub off on this place. I don't know. May I speak candidly? I expect nothing less from my priest. Are you not perhaps laying too much at Major Burns' feet?
Oh.
Father, come on. You know what a nightmare this place can be when Frank gets even one little taste of entitlement. He goes completely GI. I'm surprised he doesn't make us all wear red, white, and blue underwear. He inspects every inch of this place, breathes down our necks, orders changes as he sees fit, and just sits in his ivory tower and
does our commands.
Yes. But Hawkeye, that's his job. Temporary as it may be. Perhaps you're expecting too much from one human man. They never proved that human part.
Hawkeye.
Yeah, okay. All right, I see what you're saying. Actually, Frank's been kept pretty busy with his kingdom falling around his ears. But Frank Burns and no. The way everyone's acting. Childish. Violent. I'm disappointed. Me. I'm disappointed in them. All of them. As if this place couldn't get any worse. As if the war wasn't bad enough. And now, they had...
My son, I've been here a long time. And do you know what I see when I look around this place? These people.
No, Father, I don't. But do you know what I see when I look around this place? At these people, do you know what I see?
No, I don't. For certain.
But I believe it's the same thing that I do.
Way to win an argument, Father.
Hey, Max, don't eat those. I like to suck all the salt off my pretzels.
Oh, Margaret, you wouldn't believe it. The mess tent was the messiest it's ever been. The food delivery man quit on me. And then when that gun went off, I thought there was an enemy intruder, you know? Something to look forward to, but it turns out it was one of our own men.
Oh, I'm here now. Tell me all about it.
Really, you can't imagine. I've been so busy signing forms for everything. Gosh, I'm sick of my own name.
Oh, Frank.
Sorry. What song is that you're playing, Father?
In a World of My Own.
Hey, Max, care to sing along?
Well, I could try. I could whistle.
Perfect. Take it away, Father.
All right.
Hey, Hawk. Listen, all that stuff I said last night, forgotten. That was yesterday. But if I ever do find a high horse, I'll gladly give you a ride.
Seems like Father Mulcahy's presence broke the spell.
Well, we know it wasn't his love of honky-tonk piano.
Psst. What? Max?
Oh, dear.
Oh! Who put that rock there? Did you put that rock there, Corporal?
Please, no, sir, I swear.
Well, just don't let it happen again.
Well, good morning, Father. Radar, do you happen to know if Major Burns is busy this morning?
This morning? Well, he just finished tripping over rocks and yelling, sir, so he should have about 10 minutes free before he starts pre-licking all the postal stamps for the day.
Good. I think it's time I paid a visit to the Ivory Tower.
Excuse me, Father?
Well, never mind, Radar.
Come in.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize you'd already begun licking. I'll come back later. Heavens no, Father. Come and sit. Sit down. I could use some company. You know, it's lonely at the top. So I hear. I'm afraid what I have to say won't be of much comfort to you. I mean to say, I've come to inquire about someone in the camp. The entertainer, Max, if that's even his real name. Oh, a spy? Oh, no, I don't think so. Though he did seem to know an awful lot about me. I'd just like to know what data you've collected on him during his stay here, if any. Well, I only let Pearson McIntyre keep him around for morale purposes. That's gonna sound like Marvin. Other than him whistling last night, I've never even seen him perform. Some showman. Well, I think we're the show. I believe he may be gaining some sick enjoyment from testing people and seeing how they react. Or perhaps knowing how they will. That little man? Ha! I could file him away in a drawer under T for tiny. All the same, Father, are you all right? You're not gonna start praying in here. No, I just wish you'd tell me all you know about him. Maybe this was a bad idea. I should speak with Max directly.
Now, wait just a minute.
Father, you came to me with this, and I think you better tell me what it is you're not saying that you wanted to tell me, but now you don't. I am acting commander, after all.
I just believe he's been doing this with other people in the camp.
Doing what?
Whispering in their ears, pushing their buttons, making them behave in ways they ordinarily wouldn't.
Well, did he say anything to you?
Yes, that's how I found out about it.
Huh. What could he possibly whisper in your ears to rattle you?
It was something concerning my parents.
He's spreading lies?
No, unfortunately.
Well, what did he say?
Please, I'd rather not repeat it.
Father, I won't tell a soul. Cross my heart and hope a house falls on me.
Well, perhaps I better whisper it.
He said that?
You? Now, don't get overexcited, Major Burns. It wasn't a lie. It just surprised me that he knew. After all,
I'm perfectly calm. Just like to say that I see now that I've been remiss in my duties here for this person to go unchecked, and I'm sorry about that, Father. But rest assured, after what you told me here today, I shall be the first man to congratulate that miniature so-and-so on his new black eye.
Oh, please, it was just an emotional disturbance. Violence isn't the answer, although it took a lot of prayer for me to not give him a good left hook myself.
That's just what they said before the war started.
What has you on the warpath now, Frank?
Yeah, got more stones to kick around? We really should put some barrels around that one.
Big talk. All talk, aren't you? Jokes, chaos, always out of uniform, k-sara, sara. Who cares? Things will work out. Army who?
Something tells me I'm getting yelled at again.
I liked it better when I did it. More dramatic.
Well, you two were busy making icy with a stranger who never, by the way, went through any of the proper channels. This outfit's friendly and can do no wrong with spending his time in between taking vows for Chum of the Year, harassing our priest. Well, if you'll excuse me, I have to go escort him out of camp using a cannon.
There won't be any need for that.
No, I can do it. He's small. He'll fit.
Frank, I've never seen you like this before.
Like what?
Standing up for someone who wasn't you.
If you only heard what he's been doing, preying on the psyche of our men like a ravenous wolf.
What happened with Father Mulcahy?
Slime whispered in his ear during the party last night. Something about his childhood. Something about his parents.
Look, Frank, Max is leaving this morning anyway as a clean bill of health. Of course, now I'd like to change that status. I'll talk to him. Trap, go see if Francis needs anything.
Right.
And Frank? Thanks for telling us.
Certainly. You know, it surprised me Father Mulcahy came to me. I always thought he kind of trusted you guys.
Well, as a wise man once tried to tell me, everyone needs a little trust put in them now and then, if they're ever going to become trustworthy.
Huh. What am I knocking for?
Just who are you exactly?
Allow me to introduce myself. I am MC, Master of Ceremonies.
You fake a good American accent.
I fake a lot of things.
Oh, how is it I missed how creepy you are? No, I was actually worried about you. You were my patient.
What changed?
What changed? Well, for starters, you got better while we all got sicker. Coincidence? I think not. And that stuff with Father Mulcahy, bringing up his past, it's none of my business, of course. If you wanted me to know, you'd have told me. But exactly how did you find out? How did you worm your way into this entire MASH unit's psyche? How did you know what buttons to press?
Simple. You let me in. This is where true conflict lies, from within. We let our feelings fester. We let our dreams go. We force down our desires.
But there will always be someone waiting in the wings, ready to offer us escape.
Just waiting for us every time we walk off the stage. If you live in this way, you will always be blind to your escape artist. And then, it will be too late.
The curtain goes down on your hatred, on your fears.
On your escape artist comes his souls, one by one.
The greatest show on earth.
War has no skin, no face, no time. And no matter how hard you try, absolutely no manners. War is lewd, ugly, seductive, and exciting. But take the makeup off, and it's also terribly human.
Okay, so you're trying to tell me what? That you're some kind of symbol of war? A walking example bringing misery wherever you go?
My dear sir, I am not your troubles. I am your escape artist. Ooh. But how often we blame the mirror when we do not like what we see.
That's your ride. We arranged transport for you back to wherever it is you came from. Just tell the driver. And hey, try not to smoke this time. I count souls too. How do you like that creep? Making us all turn against one another. Well, we turned. Well, sure, but you didn't mean to. I mean, honestly, I always thought it wouldn't take very much for the weaklings around here to cave, but I was wrong. It took him. Maybe that really wasn't very much at all. When you know where to apply the pressure.
One last thing. Please smile for the camera. Auf Wiedersehen. Au revoir. Goodbye.
Well, there he goes. Good riddance. Frank, now that that's over, I guess I can tell you this.
Yes?
You've got a stamp on your tongue.
I do?
So I have. Father, I hate to pry, and I'm not. But if you ever need to talk about anything, for any reason, you can...
Thank you, Hawkeye.
Well, another day, perhaps.
Right.
I don't know how you do it, Father. I don't know how you do it.
Do what?
This. The MC, Master of Creepiness, everything. Wake up every day and face another sunset under these conditions. While the rest of us are tearing our hair out and grumbling under our breath, you somehow manage to remain kind and calm. You're giving me too much credit.
But I did learn early on in my seminary training that it is possible to look at darkness.
Look.
But one must never stare.
I may have looked a beat too long this time. I think I've lost my jocularity for a while, too.
Now don't say that. Humor is a blessing. Just like kindness and joy. It's the intention behind it that matters. If you'll excuse me, I have to go write a letter to my parents. I worry about them when they travel to a new city. They're with the circus, you know. Lion tamers.
Are you serious?
No. But it made you smile, didn't it?
Well, until next time, this has been Kitchen Home. Bye! Happy summer, everybody! Stay cool.